And I believe what it says. Who it says I am, that's who I am. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. That's who I am. This is my Bible. This is God's word to me. His supernatural word to be a supernatural being. Because he's a supernatural God. And I can do what it says I can do. I can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me. That's what it says. So right now I'm ready to hear the word. My heart is already positioned and conditioned to believe the word. For with my heart, I must believe. And where I have need of change, I'm ready to be changed by the living, breathing word of God. And I'll never, 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 never be the same again after I have heard, believed, received, and applied the word today. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. I thank God for Brother James Shelton this morning. Amen. Amen. Such a gift to the body of Christ. And we were in the house this past Wednesday together. Amen. And I was playing the hymn. You know, these young musicians, they forget the hymns. Amen. But I thank God for him being a teachable man of God. He and his wife and their children, we honor them in this house. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. I want you to go with me to the Gospel of Mark, chapter number 14. The Gospel of Mark, chapter number 14. And we're going to pick up on our message for the next few weeks. And we want it to be known that we believe that the clue of the Lord in this hour is that he is raising and birthing women as never before. Everybody needs to hear what God is getting ready to do and is doing. The other day, the President of the United States and Congress confirmed the first African-American female attorney general. Come on, somebody ought to say hallelujah. And so the Pastor G said, don't miss the clues. Don't be at the airport when your ship comes in. Amen. And so we're watching how this thing is panning out. We're watching how this thing is panning out. Amen. And this is what the song that the Lord said to me. Lord, whatever you're doing in this season, don't do it without me. Sing it with me now. Lord, whatever you do in this season, don't do it without me. I said, I feel it. I smell it.
Yes.
Ooh. It's all good.
Hey.
It's all good.
Faith. We saw the Holy Spirit move towards this different, the charismatic, the
outbursts of the Holy Spirit. We see different seasons where Jesus is saving that which is lost. So I want to declare, I want it to be known that the clues are all around us that who he is seeking to save now will be winning. This is going to be one of the greatest moves that we have ever seen that is going to unlock and release the voice of women as never before. Now I want to say to all of our men, we need you to support the move of God.
Amen. Amen.
We need you to help us. We need you to work with us. We need you to support. We need you to invest. We are not, we cannot do it. We don't want to do it without our men. This is not a men bashing message. Because I know that it takes your strength. If we have to fight, we need you to fight for us. We don't need you to be criticized because we don't need you to come against us. We don't need you to cut our legs out from under us, and we don't need you to get jealous of us. Because after this move where God is going to raise women, the next move is women will then birth men. Because a man cannot birth a man.
No.
There is something very perverted that is going on in the body of Christ. Where everybody now is looking for a father. Everybody want a father. We want a father. We want a father. And so we see all of these father-son relationships in the body of Christ. And I want to decree to you that no man can birth another man.
No man.
That even in the spiritual order of God, that's out of order. Perversion has crept into the church on the way. Ungodly men have crept into the church unaware and turned what was grace into lasciviousness. So we have all of these kind of perverted relationships. Oh, that's my father. That's my father. Oh, yes, that's my son. That's my son. And then I always pose the question, but who is your mother?
Come on, bitch.
Who is your mother? Are you aware that every major spiritual move and movement, denomination, or organization was birthed out by a woman? Are you aware of what has happened in church history where even the four-spread gospel ministry and even the move of the Holy Spirit that now Benny Hinn ushers in takes out? It's because of women. Catherine Kuhlman birthed him. When you think about the Four-Spread Gospel Church, you think about this wonderful, wonderful ministry that's there. But it was Amy Simple McPherson who actually birthed that work out. And these are just current modern-day women of God, apostles, who have gone before us to set in place, now, I believe, the structure so that now the sons can take it. I believe that in this season that what the clues are saying, not just in the church, but in the marketplace, in politics, in industry, even in the economy, in the Congress, in the Senate, we are seeing God raise up women. So it is important and imperative to us that we correct the era of systemic sexism that is